Collins, I be Hello guys, what's up? Thank you so much for watching Circuits Bazaar. So today we are going to make a traffic light using 555 timer IC and 4017 counter IC. So there are lots of circuit available on the internet, so you can select any circuit from there, but we are going to use this circuit. As you know that we before this video we had made a video on 555 timer IC, and the main project name was how to blink LED using 555 timer IC. So we will use that circuit so that it will take very less time to generate this circuit, and there will be less wastage of time to develop this circuit, right? So now we are going to see that 555 timer IC circuit, and we will take that circuit and then further we'll proceed toward our main circuit, right? So this is the circuit. This is LED blinking circuit. If you want to see the video, you can watch the previous video. I think we didn't save that circuit, so we can go toward another circuit which we have made recently. The name of that circuit is LED Chaser. So this is the LED Chaser circuit. So we can get the 555 timer and 4017 counter IC from that circuit. And if you want to see the video of this circuit, you can see the video of this circuit. Previous video was of this 555 timer and 4017 counter IC circuit, right? So if you want to completely know how to design this circuit, you can watch that video and you will get the idea, right? So now according to our this circuit, our now requirement is design traffic light using 555 timer and 4017 counter IC. So we will make that circuit from this circuit, right? So we don't need these 8 number of LEDs, so we will delete them. So we will left click and select all these ID, and then right click and then delete. So these LEDs are deleted now. Next, see the circuit diagram. So this is the circuit diagram. So we need diode over here. So these are the 4 diode and then 2 diode, right? So basically we need 6 number of diodes. So we will take 6 number of diodes, go to component mode, then pick component library, okay, then search diode. So this is the diode, select it. Okay, you need 6 diodes, so these are the 4 diode we have taken. Now next 2 diode we will take. Cancel, we don't want to replace the component. Okay, now next you need what? Green LED. So we will select green LED, go to component mode, go to pick library, then LED. After that you have to go to optoelectronics, then select green LED over here. So this is the green LED, animated LED we have to take. Click OK. So this is the green LED. Now what is next LED we needed? Amber LED and red LED. Amber means yellow LED. Yellow LED we had already taken, so this is the yellow LED, and next is red LED. So go to pick and then write down LED, optoelectronics, then red LED. So this is the red LED, right? Select it. Now delete this section as well, because we don't need this section. The first LED, which is on pin number 1569, so we will connect diode to 1569. This is 1, then 5, then 6, then 9. 9, right? And pin 15, pin, see what data is given to the pin number 15. 15 pin is actually 22k, and this is the capacitor, right? So let's see, we will do one thing, we will take 1 microfarad capacitor and then 22k resistor. We will connect pin number 15 over there. So this is the capacitor, this is the resistor. Rotate the resistor anti-clockwise. Ground the resistor. This is another end. This is capacitor. Change the value of capacitor to what? 1 microfarad and resistor to 22 microfarad. So this is 22 microfarad. Or you can write down mu only. Okay, no, this is 22k and this is value 1 microfarad. So just delete all these 3 0, right? So connect pin number 15 in between resistor and this capacitor. Now these two diode, next two diode is connected to pin number 10 and 11. So this is pin number 10 and this is pin number, sorry, this is pin number 11 and this is pin number 10. They are sorted, all the diode are sorted with each other, the output of this diode. All right, now green LED is connected to on these 4 diode. So before that we have to take a resistor as well. So this is the resistor and one resistor over here. So to get a proper intensity of light, what you can do, you can make it 100 ohm, because we are working on 5 volt 100 ohm. So green LED, this is the green LED, rotate it anti-clockwise, move it over here, and then this is on 2 diode we have connected, amber LED means yellow LED. So this is the yellow LED, anti-clockwise, move it here, and next LED is the red LED, and red LED is connected to pin number what? 12. So pin number 12 is here, so you can connect red LED over here, right? So drag this LED, right click, then go to drag of object. So place it here, then right click, anti-clockwise. This is red LED and it is connected to pin number 12, but before that we have to take a resistor as well. So this is the resistor, change the value of this resistor to 100 ohm, pin number connected to pin number 12. Right, now connect these LEDs. Ground it, the ground of LED should be grounded. Now let's play it. Red LED is on and data is not shifted. Data is not getting shift, so there is some problem. So we will do one thing, we will remove this and this and directly connect to pin number 15 to VCC and let's see what happens. First of all, increase the speed of traffic light, make it 5. Okay. Play. Nothing is going on even now. So pin number 15 we will ground. Now let's see. Now it's working fine. Pin number 15 you have to ground. So you can see traffic light is should be a little bit slow. So it should be slow. So we will do one thing, we will increase the value of this capacitance to increase the timing of traffic light. So we will do it, make it like 40, right? Timing will be increased eight times. So now play it. So you can see red LED is on now, after that yellow, then green. Okay, so yellow LED is for a very small amount of time, and you can see this traffic light is working perfectly. And you can implement this circuit on the hardware. If you need any help to implement this circuit on hardware, then let me know in the comment box. This is well tested circuit. You can make it on hardware and it will definitely work, because we had already implemented this circuit on the hardware, right? You can take the screenshot of this circuit so that you can make it. Thanks for watching the video.